the 2K Sports pregame show.
This is 2K Sports. I'm Ernie Johnson. Welcome to the NBA. We're joined by the legends, Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. And coming right up, we'll see this home squad playing against the San Antonio Spurs. Last outing for the Spurs, unsuccessful, coming away with a loss to the Warriors at Oracle Arena. That game was a shootout. Defense will be the key tonight for them to bounce back with a win. You know, we've heard so long that Greg Popovich is one of the best coaches in the NBA, if not the best. What sets him apart, Kenny?
Well,
greetings, everyone. Glad to have you here with us on this Wednesday night edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony with Doris Burke on our sideline. Looking at San Antonio, they want to turn it around after the loss to the Golden State Warriors. And that was a real body blow for them. They got taken apart both offensively and defensively.
Probably their poorest defensive effort all season long. I mean, at home, that kind of D is not going to cut it. Never mind when you're on the road.
Hey, I don't know, guys. This may be all speculation. Perhaps they had a bad flight into town the night before, and we all know a rough flight in can lead to turbulence on the court.
Tip-off goes to Seattle. Now a chance, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. The starting five on the floor. On the floor for San Antonio. Hayward out there with Saric. Then it's Holiday. Then there's Gordon. And it's Davis in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Here we go with Holiday running it up the court. And Hayward gets it to go.
How about the quick hands on the steal and the quick feet on the break?
Yeah, a careless, silly mistake there, though. I mean, coughing the ball up and then not being quick enough to get back on defense, that's costly.
And it's Eric Gordon with the foul. That's his first foul.
That's a quick foul to pick up here in the opening quarter.
Guarded by Holiday. Up and in on the layup.
Clearly, he's one of the best there is in the business when it comes to making that lead pass.
And the pass to Davis. Nifty move. It's good, the assist that time from Holiday.
Well, Merry Christmas. I mean, that was a freebie.
And it's Seattle with the ball. They are coming off that win against Atlanta.
And you know what? Exactly what had to be done in terms of winning on the road. Never allowed any momentum to build up against them. Kept the crowd out of the game. And for every punch they took, they had a counter.
I was very impressed, Greg, with the way they stood their ground. Even when they were on their heels some, coming through those moments where they were backing up a bit. That's what it takes on the road. You've got to show that kind of fortitude and resilience.
George dishes to Towns. His second shot goes in, off to a good start, 2 for 2.
Wow, what a pass there. He made that a very easy basket with that setup.
Now let's find out what head coach Greg Popovich had to say to Doris Burke. Doris?
Kevin, he told me that basically on the defensive end, if they can do a good job on their outside shooters, everything else should fall into place. He said, listen, if we can force them to work the ball inside on a consistent basis, we feel like we have an excellent chance to win. We'll see, guys.
Thank you, Doris. Devising a strategy, Clark, to take away that three-point shot.
Yeah, I think it's an important part of the defensive game plan because teams nowadays are just too good to not defend them from behind the three-point line.
San Antonio with the rebound. And Holiday kicks to Gordon. For the three. One up, one down. Points with his first shot this game.
They really can't allow him too many open looks like that. I mean, that's just inviting trouble.
They set the pick. Passes it to Porzingis. Towns wide open. Knocks down the 10-footer. Towns has got 6.
You know, you're going to have success when you can start out shooting 80% from the game. So early offensively, they've been great. That's the way you like to start.
Now, here is Holiday. He had an 18-point outing in the last game against the Warriors in Oakland.
And Kevin, a remarkable night for him, passing the basketball as well. He did a great job racking up the assist.
2 on the clock. Saric misses. For Seattle, they've gone 4 of 5 from the field so far. And here's George for 3. Oh, he got hacked on the 3-pointer. Go ahead to the line. It's going to go on Gordon Hayward. Seattle shooting their initial free throws of the game right here. And he makes the first.
At the 1 for 2.
And so he hits both. And here's Gordon. Last game he had 12. Feeds it to Davis. Nice ball movement by San Antonio. Holiday, the pass to Hayward. It's good, the assist that time from Holiday. Holiday's got 3 assists in the game.
And a really good way to start the game. He's a guy who, if he gets it going early, he's going to give you problems. Yeah, that's a tough call right there, and really a tough break for the D.
Greg, no problem for me with that call. I mean, he was still sliding right there.
Let's go. And Towns gets it to go. Towns has got 8 points.
Offensively, it's been a perfect quarter for him. He hasn't missed a single shot.
And Holiday kicks to Saric. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down. Guys, no one team gaining control early on.
Give and take, back and forth, the whole way this far.
Yeah, you look at the lead change, 6 already.
Heads up play there, guys, on the assist and the finish.
Pass to Davis. To the inside. Stolen away. Now here's Towns. He picked up 21 points in their last win against Atlanta. In the corner, it's Gordon. Again, the Spurs, good for two.
What a passing display he has put on here tonight.
Yeah, he's spoiling this pick. I mean, this just another fantastic dime dropped right there. That one certainly should make the highlight reel.
Here's Porzingis. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
And I love the fact that he didn't have to slow down or adjust there. The pass was just timed perfectly.
Holiday goes in. Free throw line jump shot. And it's sent back by George. Mr. Porzingis. Dishes it to Towns. And he connects on the jumper. The screen did the trick. Towns has got 10.
Boy, guys, they've shown some great passing on their last few trips down the floor. Excellent.
Four straight passes leading to scores. Great team play.
And San Antonio calls the first timeout of the game.
And I think taking a time here to talk things over is a smart idea.
One of the things you want to do is make sure everybody is clearly on the same page with the game plan. And sometimes you need a timeout to make sure that's the case.
Here's what San Antonio's going with right now. Sanders checked in for Davis. Hezonja comes in for Saric. And Tim Hardaway Jr. subbed in for Eric Gordon. And it's Seattle with the ball. After Gordon Hayward's miss, the dish now to Towns. Inside. Taken away by Holiday. In transition, here comes San Antonio. And Hezonja gets it to go.
That is such good work to make this a one-possession game. Terrific steal to get it all started.
And it's one thing to get the steal, but to so alertly turn it into a transition opportunity, even better.
Porzingis can't hit.
Oh, nice play on D. Got that hand in the face and prevented him there from getting an easy look.
Exactly. Alert and aware. Really reacted quickly to that shot attempt.
For Seattle, they've gone 8 of 11 in the first quarter. They'll take that percentage any night. George dishes to Towns. And it's rebounded by Drew Holiday. Towns, the pass to Porzingis. Off the iron that time. San Antonio's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Hardaway kicks to Holiday. Here is Hayward. He had a 24-point outing in their last game against Golden State.
And also, give him credit for his ability to pass the basketball. He was always looking for the open man.
Clock at 2. Hardaway, no good.
That's a shot he's got to hit. You don't get many looks better from that range.
Nobody near George. Drills it from outside. George has got 5 points so far.
That's just run of the mill for him. A typical day at the office. He's one of the more skilled offensive players out there.
San Antonio calls timeout. A platoon swap here for Seattle. Seattle on defense. They lead by 4. Spurs passing it around. Johnson outside. 5 to shoot. Lobs it up. Got a hand on it. Here's Coleman.
Oh, wow.
Boom, he jams it straight down.
No doubt that is within his range.
Well, I would hope so. He's a pro, and it was only a one-footer. Come on now.
That was a nice replay brought to you by Kia. Here's Hezonja. 11 points for him in that last game against Golden State.
Yeah, but he was also a force on the defensive side. 2 blocks. shots, it also altered a ton of shots. And no matter who it is, that kind of D isn't going to get it done.
Smith outside. There's the pass to Coleman. Stripped away. 4-on-3 break. Here's Stojic. Basket is good. The assist from Johnson. And it's now only a one-point Seattle lead.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also going their way.
Well, I don't think there's any question about it. They came focused and ready to play. I mean, they're doing everything they can to put things in their favor. You earn that, and they're actually earning it well right now.
Some good defense in the NBA, so let's check out the leader.
You know, I don't think all the time that defensive-minded teams get the credit they deserve. And sometimes I think that teams like this aren't as exciting to watch. But you know what? It's effective. Limiting your opponent's points goes a long way towards giving you the results you're looking for.
San Antonio's gone 2-of-4 from beyond the arc to start the game. Here's Azania, and again, it's the Spurs from deep.
Lead changes hands once more. There has been no separation between these two teams.
You know, it's made for one heck of an entertaining game. Even when it hasn't been the best basketball being played, it sure has been fun to watch. I think they need to get much more disruptive defensively. They can't just keep allowing these easy baskets.
That's got to be job number one right now. Nothing easy on the inside.
Passes it to Coleman. Shot no good. Good work defensively by Johnson. San Antonio's gone 3-of-5 from three-point land so far in the ballgame. Out of bounds. Seattle will take possession. There's 18 seconds left to play here in the first. Smith against Hardaway. Here's Coleman. Good D by Sanders.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up for that one.
It's all tied in Seattle, and we'll return shortly. Well, it's been a tight one so far as we get the second quarter going back here. And let's quickly break down the game we've seen from Seattle. Guys?
This is almost like a volleyball game when you watch just how many shots they blocked or altered.
Well, how about this? A lot of side outs for them the way they've swatted shots away. That's a volleyball term, by the way, folks.
Yeah. Or handball.
I like that. Or handball.
Yeah, either
as well.
One of the two. They're knocking a lot away.
Yeah.
San Antonio's gone 3-of-6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. They've got Ricky Rubio. Porzingis is out there with Towns. Then it's Paul George. And it's Watkins in at the three. That's the lineup in the game for Seattle. Now here is Holiday. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Here's George. Kicks it to Towns. Back to Rubio. Some nice ball movement here by Seattle. George dishes to Towns. Hayward against George. Just four to shoot. And Towns gets it to go. San Antonio trailing here. And Holiday kicks to Davis. He dishes it to Hayward. Shot by Gordon, wide open. The feed to Holiday. Fires the jumper from the corner and nails it. Holiday's got the game tied up here for San Antonio.
And good passing, setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Dime dropping delights is what I call it.
Yeah, that's a nice pass. I will give you that one.
Yeah, he's on the money, that's no doubt. Here's Porzingis. He's been playing a big part of their offensive scheme, averaging around 15.5 points a game.
He shot the ball exceptionally well as they've built this lead for themselves here.
Now here is Holiday. And Sarge kicks to Gordon. They set the pick. The shot by Hayward, wide open. Chance there to take the lead, missing. To the paint, and George with the stop.
Boy, oh boy, to be young again. My, oh my. Got me thinking back to my days.
Oh, yeah, right. Does make you nostalgic, doesn't it?
Oh, well, man. Speak for yourself, because I could never throw it down like that, but I will say it sure looks fun, doesn't it?
Here's Holiday after the basket by Seattle, and Hayward gets it to go. For Seattle, they've gone 3 of 4 from the floor here in the second quarter. Towns, the pass to Rubio. Quarter two and just under 2.5 minutes gone by. Towns, no luck.
Now, nice work there to contest the finish inside.
You know, they got the shot they wanted, but his defense, deterred them from those plans.
And Seattle making a change here. Here is Davis. Right now averaging about 5 points a game. Here's Saric. And that one falls, coming off of Davis's feed.
And he came off that screen, and he just didn't get over the top of it.
Yep, weren't there in time enough to challenge, Greg. And when that's the case, you can mark those up for him. I tell you what, folks, I bet he won't miss that shot next time he takes it.
Gordon with it. Now guarded by Towns. Towns comes with a double team. Hayward's got space. Off the left rim and out.
Man, that is a missed opportunity right there.
And he'll be the... First to tell you, Greg, that's one he should have knocked down.
Now here is Holiday. He's tightly guarded. Here's Davis, and fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
Clearly a foul.
Yeah, he took a shot there. Earned those free throws.
This is his first free throw of the game. And that one falls, and that puts him up by 1 point. Curry's checked in for Seattle. And both free throws good for Davis. Curry with it. Guarded by Holiday. Back to Curry. He kicks to Towns. 6 on the shot clock. Good. Towns has got 6 in the quarter.
Really hard to find fault with anything he's doing this quarter. At least at the offensive end.
There's the pick. Holiday against George. Inside. The steal. And pushing it up. Here's Seattle. Offensive rebound. Curry outside. Misses that one. He's 0 for 1 from the floor. San Antonio's gone 3 of 7 tonight from 3-point territory. Now Davis. He feeds it to Holiday. Double team on Holiday. Back to Davis. Just 5 on the clock. Hayward goes in. Goes up high. For the two-handed dunk.
And guys, this game won't be close for long if they keep giving up dunks like that.
No, it won't, G. You're right. A glaring error defensively and letting him get all the way to the basket that time.
But it's only 2 points. I mean, it was flashy, no doubt. But still, it only counts for two. Two is all.
And Seattle making a change here. Monty Unis has checked in. Hezonja, he's checked in for the Spurs. Here's Holiday. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for the Spurs.
They've been making some really nice passes out there. Excellent passing. That could set the tone for the rest of the game.
And that's what's created a rhythm for them offensively. That's also why you see them knocking down that mid-range jump shot.
Hardaway's checked in for San Antonio. Stolen by a solo fast break. Here's Hezonja. Yes, and it's Holiday with the assist that time. Holiday's got assist number 8 here in this one already.
Just not happy with how his team is playing, and they just have been on the wrong side of this run.
Yeah, and you know what, Greg? Sometimes just a pause in the action, which is what a timeout can give you, is enough to change things around.
Larry Sanders has checked in for Gordon Hayward. Spurs making a switch here.
Johnson. Stojic.
And it's Seattle with the ball. 6 point game. Sanders with the steal. Hardaway passes to Hezonja. No good. Seattle goes the other way with it. Following this game, they hit the road to challenge the Suns at U.S. Airways Center in Phoenix. That'll be just one game played away from home for them.
And the defense scattered all over the place on the break. Nice job finding the wide open three.
San Antonio with the ball. Seattle able to drain the three. Johnson the screen. Wide open. And it's in after a nice bounce off the right side. Hezonja's got 4 this quarter.
That was an outstanding pick that gave him the room to bury the jump shot. Underrated, but not undervalued.
Coleman, Sanders covering. Curry with a wide open look. The three-pointer no good. San Antonio leading by 5. Feeds to Johnson. Seattle grabs the miss.
That's the kind of D you need when he's got the ball near the hoop. They were all over him.
Coleman. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot 2.
Spurs foul called.
While we have a break in the action, now let's check out the league's best shooting teams.
Kevin, I've always said shooting percentage individually and for a team is a function of the kinds of shots you get. This team leads the league in shooting percentage because, 1, they have good shooters, but 2, they take high-quality shots. They're a very disciplined group.
And Seattle making a change here. Smith has checked in.
And what an advantage. You really feel like you can always trust him when he's at the line.
And the bucket counts, and he's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a 3-point play.
4 of their last 5 makes came off of a high-quality shot inside.
Textbook, really, when you look at how they're playing. They are having their way down low. And they're really getting more points at the free throw line here in the second quarter.
And, Greg, definitely that's one of the reasons they're in front right now.
Coleman, the pass to Monta Unis. Clock at 4. That's a 2 from Smith, and he hits it just before the shot clock expires. San Antonio leading by 3. Pass to Johnson. Here's Hardaway. That's in there, Johnson with the assist. Hardaway has got 5 points so far.
Hard to get that one off with the size difference there. That makes it a tough individual matchup for him, especially down low.
Well, took on the big guys going in there and challenging them like he did. But, boy, that was a nice job.
Hezonja's shot is off.
not able to find it here in the second. He's off stride and off track just a bit after that one he had earlier.
And the officials call a traveling violation. Here we are in November. Let's see how things are shaking out in the West early in the season. Taking a look at Seattle. So far, they've got the fourth best record in the conference. And, of course, the Spurs. They're much further down in the standings right now.
And I think for Seattle, they've stayed right there, just in sniffing distance of the conference leaders. That's a solid accomplishment at this stage of the season.
You know, I thought maybe they'd have it in them to actually join those leaders this season. But you're right, it's still nice work considering where they are.
And here's the fast break. Rubio, the pass to Coleman. 1:33 left in the first half. Seattle missing again. San Antonio leading by five. Pass to Johnson. Johnson with a screen on Rubio. Fires for three, and Hezonja gets it to go. Hezonja's got 14 points.
You know, he's putting on an outstanding offensive display, and he may just be getting warmed up here.
Rubio against Johnson. Here's your bow. Out to Smith. Second shot opportunity, and he drops that one in. Smith's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Really good job there. That's the definition of the inside-out game.
43 seconds left in the first half of basketball. Here's Hezonja. He's got 14. Here's Stojic. And again, it's San Antonio with a three.
And really, the defense didn't do a lot to fight around that screen on that possession.
Smith dishes to Monte Yunus. Six to shoot. Coleman. Here's your bow. And there's the pass to Coleman. Another shot, and the layup is good.
Oh, I love that dish down low.
Stojic. The shot is off, and...
Thanks, Kevin Cook.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Ernie Johnson here again with Kenny Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. We welcome you back to the 2K Sports Halftime Show. A pretty close game for the Spurs throughout the first quarter. Nothing seemed to give way on either side of the scoring column as they wrapped up the period all knotted up. In the second quarter, we began to see what they're capable of when everything starts clicking as they pulled out to a 7-point lead by the end of the half. And Shaq, what are your thoughts on how San Antonio played?
Well, the perimeter shooting is the reason they're ahead. I think we'll probably see more of that in the second half, especially if they can stay hot. Man, it's so hot, I gotta take my suit off.
How about you, Kenny? What did you think about this home team?
Well, they just didn't produce enough offense. I don't know if it's because they were expending so much energy on the defensive end, but clearly they have to take a look at this. What plays are we calling? And how can we improve that? And they have to do it fast, because if they don't, this game is gonna run away from them.
And that'll do it for now, as the second half of our game is about to get underway. Kevin Harlan has the call.
And the second half about to start here in just a few moments. Carl Anthony Towns has been sensational.
Yeah, he's played just a smart game overall offensively, looking for and finding the gaps in the defense, and also terrific shot selection.
Greg, that's exactly what we're talking about when we talk about being efficient as an offensive player. Fully on display there with him.
Here's who Greg Popovich is starting in the second half. Holiday out there with Gordon, then it's Hayward, then there's Davis, and it's Saric in at the four. And Towns gets it to go.
Really, the defense is helpless to stop a layup right there. Just too much of an advantage in terms of the mismatch.
Spurs leading by seven. And Holiday kicks to Saric. Yes, and it's Holiday with the assist that time. That's 7 points for Dario Saric. Here's Porzingis, dishes it to Towns. Outside for George, and stolen by Hayward. A finish, and it's blocked. One-on-one fast break, and he lobs it up toward the rim. It's hauled in by Gordon.
Oh, boy, that would have been a nice alley-oop.
Boy, I really liked the thought on that play, but didn't quite get it executed. Almost made a spectacular play. A little bit of a defensive breakdown there. He's not the guy you want to leave open on the perimeter. You've got to stay attached to him.
He got right to the cup using that screen. And that's now 9 points for Paul George. The Spurs have gone 3 of 4 so far in the third quarter from the field. Pretty good start to the half. And Saric kicks to Gordon. There's the dish to Holiday. No good with the triple.
Good little two-man action there, but they just can't get the shot to fall.
Yeah, but that was a beauty. Good-looking shot, well-executed play. I wouldn't be surprised to see them go back to it.
And after his last game, really not surprised to see him as hot as he is here tonight.
George passes to Porzingis. Now here's Towns. Defense is right there. Stolen by Gordon. And now here comes Gordon leading the break. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one, drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there.
Looking at the game for Hayward, 10 points and the one steal.
And guys, really impossible to say where he's been better, offensively or defensively.
I agree with you, Greg. I mean, he's not missed a beat at either end. That's obvious.
And it's George finishing it off.
Now that's finishing your work right there.
Powerful two-hand, Jim. You're right.
And I tell you what, if he's got a few more of those in him, this lead will start shrinking even further.
Now here's Gordon. He has 5. Saric with the screen for Hayward. Down low. It's deflected. And it's out of bounds. The Spurs able to retain possession here. A touch over 2.5 minutes of basketball played here in the third quarter. 3 on the clock. Holiday with the 3. Here's Davis. And finally they hit one. Davis has got 4 this quarter.
And guys, that kind of sums it up right there. I mean, one team getting after it, hustling the rebounds, the putbacks. The other team just a step slow.
Seattle trails by 10. George up top, defended by Hayward. George double teamed. Hits the 3-point bomb. He has 5.
And just a step ahead of the D in that possession there, making the pass, nice assist.
Hayward kicks to Davis. The basket good off the assist from Hayward. That's 10 points for Davis.
He had his head on the swivel and was able to pick out the pass and get the assist.
Here's Towns. Passes it to Porzingis. Kicks it to Towns. He dishes it to George. Some nice ball movement here by Seattle. Watkins passes to Porzingis. Can't hit from 12.
They really depend on him to convert those chances. A lot of times, even with solid D draped on it, they expect him to make it.
To the paint. Here's Davis. They get it back. A second chance effort. And Hayward gets it to go. Hayward's got 13.
And really, it looks like he may just try to take this thing over on his own and really build that lead up.
Towns sets the pick for George. And Eric Gordon pulls it down.
And if the shot's not there, you've got to understand that. Move the basketball.
Yeah, exactly. And I'm not quite sure what his mindset or what he was thinking there. I mean, that was just a terrible shot.
I love the ball movement there. He put that on a silver platter. Just served him up. You know what? I think he had to call timeout right now just to get his guys to regroup because they were really ragged out there.
Yeah, they've got to get some things. Straightened out, and sometimes the best way to do that
is with the timeout. They look to be overwhelmed right now.
Now the feed to Towns. It's stolen by Davis. Hayward goes in. Takes a big high bounce and goes in. Hayward's got 5 points now this quarter. And a breakdown here, guys. The hustle stats for the Spurs.
Boy, they're hounding, harassing effort at the defensive end. Very impressive. And they force quite a few turnovers as a result.
And also, guys, they take a lot of pride in their ability to rebound the basketball, especially on the offensive end.
And yes, sir, that one drops.
You know, maybe he's not one of the elite sharpshooters, but even still, that's not a shot the D can afford to give him.
It's still early on in this new basketball season for San Antonio, and here's where they sit in the NBA rankings. 7th in blocks, 11th in three-point field goal percentage, and they're in the top half of the league in scoring as well. Not too shabby.
And going back to their block shots, they're fearless, challenging shooters and contesting everything. You end up on a few posters, but I love that. Willingness to take a stand defensively.
Smith checked in for Seattle. The Spurs also with the sub. Hezonja, he's checked in for Davis. Smith outside. They set the pick from deep three-point range, and again Seattle with the triple.
The D with very little pressure on their perimeter shooters. Three of the last five baskets they've allowed have been of the three-point variety.
And you need the defense to stop the bleeding.
Now here's Hayward. He's got 17. Tried to come right back with a three of his own, but it's no good. Towns sets the pick for Smith. Here's Porzingis, guarded by Holiday. Shot is good, and the Spurs lead is cut down now to just 10 points with that basket from Porzingis.
And he just big boyed him right there. The height advantage he's got down low, really difficult for them to defend.
Now here is Holiday. He has 7. Towns with the steal. Pass to Porzingis. This one for 3. And another 3 for Seattle. And we'll get a look at how the Hustlestat game has been going for Seattle.
Defensively, they played with a lot of energy, and the steals we've seen are a result of that aggressiveness.
You know, adding on to that, their block totals tonight, and you see how feisty they've been on the defensive end this game.
Ricky Rubio checked in for Paul George. Sanders checked in for San Antonio. Tim Hardaway Jr. comes in for Eric Gordon. Watkins connects from three-point range. He has 5.
All these open threes they're giving up have really been the driving force of this run.
And the points are starting to add up in a hurry, especially when you're giving up those looks from deep. That's what we call good defense in the paint, worth its weight in gold.
It absolutely is, and maybe even more than that. I mean, you saw it right there. Without his presence, that's an easy basket.
Kicks it out to Rubio. And it's Seattle with another.
It seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. I mean, that's just exquisite ball movement.
And that's because the ball is looking for the best shot, and it's really paid off for them during the run. And they needed that. Their lead is getting smaller by the minute.
Yeah, I agree with you. Good possession there. They had to stem the tide of this comeback a little bit, and I think they did with that play there.
Here's Porzingis. He's got 7. No one near him. Out to Smith. Good. And San Antonio will go the other way with it. At one point, they led by 16. This game against Seattle is the first time they've met this year. And the rejection by Smith. And it goes out of bounds. That one is off Smith. Here's Hardaway. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot 2. Here's a peek now at the 2K leaderboard. This year, these teams have made the most of their offensive rebounds.
One of the better rebounding teams in the league, especially on the offensive end. They never take that for granted in terms of whether the shot's going in.
Both good from the line that time. And it's Seattle with the ball. They trail by six. There's a screen by Motiejunas. Smith the pass to Coleman. Rubio outside. Three on the clock. Seattle needs to get off a shot. Here's Watkins. And good. Got the English that time as it falls. He's got seven.
Just the height separation on that mid-range jumper. Excellent job of taking advantage.
Pisania's shot is off. Seattle with the ball. They're on an 18-6 run. Feeds to Motiejunas. Watkins. Sanders covering. Watkins passes to Rubio. It's tipped. Sanders with the steal. Gets that one through the hole. Make them now 7-13 in this game.
They haven't been as aggressive from outside as they were in the first half. They're playing smart with the lead. I like that. They're being very selective and deliberate in their offense. That's a good strategy when you're on top.
And it's Seattle with the ball. Six-point game. Motiejunas passes to Coleman. Here's Smith. Makes it off the glass. Smith's got 5 points now this quarter.
Boy, they are passing the ball very crisply right now.
They really are, and their last three buckets have come by way of an assist.
Screen by Sanders to the inside. No luck. Good D by Rubio.
Those are chances almost always you can rely on him to get you 2 points, but the D just enough to keep him out of rhythm.
Now, here's Rubio. Motiejunas in the post. Guarded by Hardaway. And that one's good. Now just a 2-point San Antonio lead.
Really a good job recognizing the mismatch. Just going up for the shot with that huge height advantage on that possession.
Some big points there. I mean, they got him on a nice play to get the ball right to the bucket.
And exactly what they're looking for down the stretch, Clark. Just more of the same.
And that does it for the third quarter. Both teams clicking offensively as we approach the fourth quarter. Spurs lead by four. And right after this, we'll bring you the start of the final quarter right here on 2K Sports. All right, we welcome you back to what's been a hard-fought battle. Fourth quarter should be good. They've got Paul George, and it's Motiejunas in at the center. That's the lineup in the game for Seattle. There's the pick. George dishes to Motiejunas. The rebound by Johnson. Johnson's got his fourth rebound in this one. And here is Saric. Pass to Davis. Nice ball movement by San Antonio. Saric misses.
Well, that's clearly a situation you want to make sure you don't give him too good of a look at.
No doubt about it. You cannot let up defensively just because he missed that one.
Coleman plays it in without an inch of room around him.
Key buckets, and we know he delivers down the stretch.
San Antonio leading. And there's the pass to Gordon. Dishes it to Davis. At the top of the key, Saric. Passes to Johnson. Fires from 18. And there. There's Eric Gordon on the assist from Wesley Johnson. And that's now 10 points for Eric Gordon. Seattle has gone 7 of 11 from deep tonight, using the three-pointer to their advantage. George passes to Coleman. Gordon against George. For the three, and another three for Seattle.
Those are the types of shots down the stretch that win you ball games.
Guys, we have seen them with a lot of good ball movement.
Well, you like the smooth operating they're showing you here. I mean, things are clicking, and more importantly, it makes them tough to defend.
Clark, what you know about Sade?
smooth operator. But I agree with you. I think we're all seeing that right now.
Yes, indeed.
The offensive rebound. It's tipped. To take the lead. Misses off the right.
Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the D.
The dish to Davis. Johnson outside. Clock at six. And Sarge kicks to Davis. The Spurs need to get a shot off here. Fires from deep. Offensive rebound, Spurs. Johnson, that's for two. And that one falls, coming off of Davis's feed. Davis has got three assists tonight.
Timeout call. Ladies and gentlemen,
Seattle calls timeout.
And did not seem happy about how things are going on right now, and maybe wants to make some changes.
I agree. I mean, just was not comfortable with the way things were set up at that particular time. And in that case, I think it's the right thing to do.
Let's catch up with Doris from the sideline.
Yes, guys, over that last break, I listened to Dave Joerger address his team. He told his team to keep looking for three-point opportunities, saying their perimeter defense isn't doing a good job getting out on our shooters. So let's keep firing away until they decide to guard us.
Pass to Coleman. Shoots it up. Kicks it to Towns. Nails the wide-open jump shot. Towns has got 20 points. San Antonio's gone 0-3 so far in the fourth quarter from long range. Davis sets a screen. Holiday dishes to Hayward. Holiday sets the pick for Hayward. On the wing, Eric Gordon. No good on the three.
Well, that defense went from poor to no defense at all.
And when he's open like that, you don't see him miss those looks very often.
To take the lead. And Davis pulls it down. The Spurs have gone just 2 of 8 in this fourth quarter. The final quarter not treating them well so far. It's blocked, and he recovers it. Holiday gets the bucket. Seattle trails by three. And there's the feed to Towns. Unloads from nine, and he hits the jumper for two. Towns has got 22 points.
How about these big shots for him in the fourth? He has been locked and loaded offensively.
Davis sets a screen. Holiday against George. Holiday goes in. The offensive rebound, Davis. That's another one for him, his fifth in just 7 shots.
Took advantage of some shoddy defense there. They've got to at least get a finger on it.
George passes to Towns. Here's Coleman. And another three for Seattle.
This guy will really make you pay if you leave him enough room outside.
San Antonio calls timeout. Carl Anthony Towns with a strong contribution so far in this one.
He just continues to light them up. They're going to have to find a way to make him work harder for his points.
A moment to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
Kevin, Greg Popovich was just going over the plan with his team. He told the team he wanted their offense to run through Davis. Coach emphasized getting him as many touches as possible, saying he is going to be one of the guys to carry us the rest of the way. Guys, we'll see how Coach's direction pays off as this one winds down. Kevin?
Great. Thanks for the report, Doris.
Well, they were sleeping on defense. The defense really didn't do its job. I mean, a little slow to react to the ball getting into the paint, that's costly.
And at this stage of a tight game, the tired legs really start to show. A defense becomes vulnerable if you can continue to pound it inside.
Spurs trail by three. Gordon kicks to Sarge. Teardrop shot. And it's Seattle with the rebound. Towns has got his sixth rebound on the night. It's George on the wing. Here's Porzingis. He's guarded by Davis. And plenty of contact on the shot. So, two free throws coming up.
No, I tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
Yeah, if you're going to foul, then make sure that you don't give a chance for the and one.
Carl Anthony Towns at the line for two.
All right, now, take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That free throw missing, and Seattle making a change here. And he sinks the second.
And even though he couldn't get all of them to fall, he did make it a two-possession game.
And it's blocked. Coach is liking, Clark, what he's seeing from his offense.
And, shoot, why wouldn't he? I mean, guys, they're filling it up with ease, executing, getting quality shots. I mean, this is fun to watch.
And, guys, they put the defense on the defensive.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, I mean, a cold stretch offensively. They desperately need a basket.
That's good, and the Seattle lead is cut down to five on the bucket. From Hayward.
Nice dime drop there from Holiday. Excellent awareness.
Porzingis passes to Watkins. Stolen by Gordon. In transition. Here come the Spurs. And the basket good. And that's now 21 points for Gordon Hayward.
That's a quick bucket there. Solid in transition.
Well, you know, he loves the chance to get out and run, and we could see right there why he does.
And the whistle blows as the basket counts, and a three-point play chance right here. One free throw coming up. On the free throw, no good. Spurs trail by five. The finish, and it's sent back by George. Watkins defended by Gordon. Watkins passes to George. Here's Towns. The shot is off. Davis with some nice D. Here's Hayward. The second chance effort, and Holiday with the lay-in. And that's a double-double for him now. 11 points and 12 assists. Outside for George. Pass to Porzingis. To the middle. Some nice ball movement here by Seattle. And Towns gets it to go.
Yeah, and he's starting to show that killer instinct this quarter, looking to extend the lead.
And Holiday kicks to Hayward. Using his post move to get the 2 points. Hayward's got 13 points here in the second half alone. Here's George. He kicks it to Towns. The pass to Porzingis. And he lobs it up. Deft touch on the alley-oop.
No hesitation at all on that alley-oop. Saw his teammate with the pass to the hoop, and bang! Lobbed it right up there for him.
And he was ready for it, elevated, made the catch. You saw the result.
And you know what, though? I like the fact that he still chose that conservative finish there, just making sure he got the deuce.
San Antonio calls timeout. They're behind by five. There's 1:54 left in the fourth quarter of this one. There's 1:54 left to play here in the fourth. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
We watch Holiday play great basketball. He has 11 points and a dozen assists.
The fundamentals have been on display. He's just done it all today, the passing and also knocking down his freebies.
And that's exactly what they've needed from him, those two things.
George dishes to Towns. Here's Porzingis. He's guarded by Davis. Here's George. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Well, when you look at the assist total, heck, they've been clearly the better team.
Here is Hayward. Poked loose. And pushing it up. Here's Seattle. Saric comes with the double team. Howard down after the assist. Let him into the lane.
And that's the classic 1-2 punch right there. I mean, nice steal. And then how about the elevation, Kevin, on the finish?
And Greg, nothing spurs some quick offense like a great play defensively.
That indicates the importance of great on-the-ball defense, as was displayed right there. Talk about doing a Rip Van Winkle on defense. Come on, guys, wake up. Why are they leaving him open at the three-point line? Come on. Nothing but bottoms for Gordon. He's got them falling right now.
Seattle has gotten off to a great start from three-point range in the final quarter. They're a perfect 3 of 3. Watkins, defended by Gordon. Watkins passes to Towns, and a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. It goes on Ed Davis.
And they had a foul to give, but you want to use it on the ground.
Yeah, I agree with you there, but at least they did get the clock stopped. That is the one saving grace of that team.
First free throw is good, and that makes it a three-point lead.
Of course, he didn't have an attempt there in the first half. He's hoping to be a little bit more active and aggressive here and draw some fouls here in the second.
So he gets them both, and it's a four-point ball game.
And that makes it a two-possession game now. Those could turn out to be vital free throws.
40 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Hayward kicks to Davis. He feeds it to Gordon. Down to five on the shot clock. For three, and it's out of bounds to the Spurs. San Antonio retains possession. San Antonio calls timeout. They're down by four. 24 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Coleman checked in for Seattle. The inbound pass. It's rebounded by Towns. And it's Seattle with the ball. They lead by four. And so they foul intentionally.
Had to foul, and on that occasion to stop the clock. That's the enemy in this situation.
And you know what, Greg? Who knows? A few misses at the stripe, and they're right there within range. You know, late game free throws are a lot different than early game free throws in terms of making them.
Shooting two.
gets the first, and that puts them up by five. And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a six-point ball game.
You've got to figure those are the free throws that officially put this game out of reach.
Hayward kicks to Holiday. Left side, Gordon. Hayward outside. Whoops, they pick off the pass. And now they decide to foul intentionally.
At the line, Coleman. At the line for two.
So the first one drops, and that makes it a seven-point lead. Second one is good. Hitting both at the line, and it's an eight-point game. And so it's Seattle winning this one. Some good competition, but the hometown advantage and their ability to stay focused, I think, Clark, made the difference.
Well, you know, at this stage, you've got to defend your home floor, and they did that.
And a chance now to send you over to Doris Burke, standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Yes, guys, I'm here with Paul George. And is the team's approach to defense key to the identity and the team's success as a whole?
It is. That's something we take pride in. That's something we always took pride in. And, you know, we know games is won on the defensive end. And we know we got to scrap it out on the offensive end, but games is won on the defensive end, and that's what Coach preaches.
Paul, thank you for your time. Guys, a young man with great insight.
Doris, thank you as always. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. This is Kevin Harlan saying thank you for tuning in. And now we'll head over to the studio with Ernie Johnson.
The 2K Sports postgame show.
Kevin, thank you, and now we get a chance to check out our Jordan Player of the Game. He had just an outstanding fourth quarter performance. He really had the fire lit under him, and down the stretch, really having a huge impact on the outcome of this game.
Just a sensational performance on a lot of levels, Ernie. Too many levels to talk about. Man, in some game, he's in the background. He doesn't get the chance to be the star of the show, but not tonight. He's the star tonight. Put him on the Hollywood Walk of Fame.
I can't imagine a player having a better night from the field than he had tonight. His shooting percentage was off the charts. He used every trick in the book to get those high percentage shots. He shot from every direction, and there was a little bit of luck here and there, but he was on fire.
And that'll do it for our broadcast tonight. Hope you enjoyed the show. For me and Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, and Kevin Harlan, and the entire 2K Sports crew, have a wonderful evening.